Well, we're standing here on the JOIDES Resolution, a drilling ship, as part of the International Ocean Discovery Program. And we are in the middle of the Ross Sea, drilling down into the seafloor to recover core back through millions of years. And that history recorded in the sediments can give us an idea about what our future might hold. So here we have a big map of Antarctica. And we are presently drilling right out here in the Ross Sea. So from the site that we're drilling, we're able to interpret the relative influence on this site from these two ice sheets and also from the ocean. Let's go to the bridge. So it might appear that the bridge is not occupied except for us, but that's because we're not underway. So while we're underway, this is a very active area. Right now the ship is being controlled by the dynamic positioning system that holds it on site. So what you see behind us is the derrick that supports the drilling string. At the bottom, almost 1 kilometer down, is a drill bit at the bottom of the hole, slowly turning and pulling up the core. So I'm a paleontologist on this expedition to Antarctica, and we're up on the core lab area, the core deck, where we work on all of the cores. Let me show you where the cores come up and where we get our samples. Where we lay out the core when it comes up. It'll be brought up out that way, which is where the derrick is, and it'll be brought in here and laid out all along this long core. We'll bring up about 9.5 meters worth, and the cortex will clean off the core, and then they'll splice the core into about 1.5 meter long segments. It'll then be taken in and split, as you see, and then taken in to be described, and the scientists will get their hands on it. Yeah, let's go back in. In this area is where we cut the cores in half. Along this table and this bench are a series of razors or a saw that'll cut the core in half, and then it'll get laid out here to an archive half, which we don't touch or sample, but it gets described, and a working half, which we sample. Out in this area is where a lot of the science team works. This is where the cores are laid out. This is a table for sampling. And over on that table is where the cores are described. So here we have a length of some sediment. It's a glacial sediment deposited actually during a time when Antarctica was a lot warmer than it is today. You can get a sense of everyone out there. They're all very busy with a task and following through with measuring all this. And we end up collecting all this information together, and while we're out here at sea, we'll actually be writing the initial reports, which becomes kind of the logbook of detail that the core will follow the core as people study it into the future. This long cylinder through here is a magnetometer. It measures the magnetic polarity of the different samples. And now we're entering into the paleontology lab. This is where I work. So we look at the microfossils in this laboratory, microfossils that are preserved in the sediments. This is my workstation, my microscope, and you can see a diatom over there on the screen, which is what I study. It helps us determine environments, paleo environments. It also helps us interpret the age of the cores by the different fossil events that we can track. Let me show you how we prepare our samples. So this is the paleontology lab where we take samples from the core. You see some rocks that look just like mud, and we wash them with some chemicals, break them down into their fine particles, and then make microscope slides of them. And we make some fine grained sediment. I don't know if you can get a sense of that, but it looks like just tiny dust particles. And these are the organisms that I study called diatoms. We then mount them on these glass slides, and that's how we examine these things.